Welcome to Talking Live. I'm Dr. Robbie Ludwig in Starshop Studios right in Times Square.
And they call this Starshop for a reason because there's a major star sitting right there.
I want to talk about this wine, which I love. And how much do I love drinking with Kathy Lee?
It doesn't get better than this, people.
I just want to know if this is like therapy because you're a doctor.
You know, it's really not, although people do leave the show and say they have a lot of fun.
Let's talk about the Housewives a little bit.
Okay.
I did not know this until I was doing research about you. You came on the second season.
I did.
I thought you were there from the beginning.
A lot of people
must have missed the first season.
You were discovered while you were a waitress, right? You were waitressing and someone said you should really be a model.
Right, I told him to quit bugging me. I took his number, I put it in my apron, and then I washed my apron.
We really need all of our voices. We need the young voices, the middle-aged, the older. I consider myself having a more enriched life if I have every age in my life because we need it. Instead of
this
kind of playing against each other, we all need each other.
Yeah, the younger you are, the more you know about what's happening now.
Yes.
The older you are, the more you know about the things that do not change.
Right. Now, there was a fun fact that I came across, and it has to do with Meghan Markle.
Yes.
And she helped you with your wedding invitations?
This is true.
Is that true?
It is
true. And that you said that she should be royal?
Well, she, at the time, she does have a very regal air. She's very kind and just sweet girl. Her ability at the calligraphy and just her manner, just I couldn't think of someone more perfect.
When it came to my role, I just said it with the accent. I said, Federico Castelluccio, Furio Giunta. And then it went into, every time I spoke, it was either in Italian or with a dialect. And so I got up and some people that didn't know me thought I really spoke that way. So that's, a couple days later, I went into the makeup trailer and I said hi to Edie, I said hi to everyone. She's getting her makeup done and I see her looking at me like this. and I sit down and I say hello to the guy who's gonna make up, do my hair and makeup. And I still see her staring at me. She goes, what happened to your accent?
Did you ever say to yourself, oh God, I'll never get into TV again, or maybe other people are right in saying that my career is over? Did you have those moments? It clearly
not the truth. Chicago Tribune reported that I'd been left for dead on the side of the road. I'm like, I didn't have to think it. They'd already put it out there. It was like, you're not going anywhere, Norval.
Everyone seemed to relate to the characters. Even though it represented this unique grouping, what do you think it is about your character development that gets so many people to relate?
Women saw themselves in, one of the characters.
Or many of them.
Many of the characters. Mm-hmm. And they were really about, characters represented like different approaches to life and different belief systems.
What was cool when you were young but isn't cool now?
Twinkies.
Okay.
And this is advice I tell people when I have
How
the
am
pleasure.
I doing as a defense attorney?
You're doing wonderful.
Okay, you're decked out like the fashionista today. You're wearing high heels. I'm still in flats.
Listen, I thought about this outfit for a week because when you are sitting with somebody who is a stylist, you want to make sure that you're doing it right. I might be doing it wrong because I don't follow rules. Okay. I kind of make up my own rules.
Right, and there is no right or wrong.
You are a star, you're amazing, and thank you so much for having me here.
Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you next week.